I think all of you are at least in having some concern about GST. Some of you know certain things and some of you are concerned in GST because all of you are going to directly involved into GST. Why do I say? If at least I'm talking about VAT, it may happen that not necessarily all of you should be involved into VAT. Similarly, when you talk about service tax, though at least as of all of you are concerned here, I see that at least service tax will be there. You are all. Correct. Which, but you don't have a control over that, it is. What you buy, whatever that person charges, na, you may not have further control. We'll come to that. There are various issues into that area, so just come to that. As far as you don't have a problem of excise, manufacturing. These are the areas we are not a concern at the one, because the service industry, mostly you are at least one, service industry, you have an impact of VAT, as well as service tax, entry tax. These are the areas which are directly you are having it out. GST, you are going to have an impact across, whether it is a manufacturer, whether it is a trader, whether it is a service provider, or any importer, all of them will have an impact of the GST. We'll understand the concept of GST. Probably we'll spend about at least 30 minutes or something to understand what is GST first. Then we can actually get into the details of that as well. Okay. So, as far as yes, association, it is one of the various associations which I'm dealing with, one of the youngest association. I heard actually, yes, you already done at least almost once in a month a seminar. Any at least association, yes, if it is taking care of actually the dissemination of knowledge, that is the hallmark. The importance of it is one, knowledge dissemination helps at least the members. So when you say that, yes, we have done at least so many seminars, that is really, it is good, at least almost once in a month, there is a good thing that has been happened. What we are talking about it is it visible? Yes. Or you want to, the lights, one light you can actually, not every light. I think that is sufficient, I think so. Okay. So, these are all things, actually, these are all your own facts. This is only from your own facts of your website and all those things. Whatever it is, this is an area which is talking about this one. Why I put it specifically, whether GST, are they talking anything about this or not, you'll see it subsequently. When you're talking about at least a trade shows or exhibitions or talking about meetings or at least about the meetings, you can organize at least meeting for corporate, or you can supply, some of the members can supply various items for the meetings. So, whether it is going to have any impact or it is a common, there is nothing, no difference at all for this. There is going to be a difference which I will explain to you when I am talking about something called place of supply. As far as when you're talking about here, as an association, you talk about source of revenue, if it's a one-time fee and a participation fee, currently there is a service tax will be there. What is going to happen in GST? I can tell you there is going to be GST. Let us keep it for the time being, there is going to be GST. When you talked about, at least, yes, the current rate of service tax is at least 14 plus 0.5 plus 0.5. What is this at least going to be? Probably let us take 18% or 20%. It has not been firmed up. There's one of the contentions which is going on. So let us actually, for the today's discussions, we'll go with us as a 18%. I'm not telling that is not the final rate. The rate is yet to be come out or announced. It may vary from, according to the sources, it may vary from 18% to 22%. What percentage will come, we have to wait and see it out as well. As far as concerned, currently when the, for the membership and other things, if you're talking about it is, if it is paid service tax of 15%, it is going to be 18%. This is the directly, if you look at it as one. whether it is going to inflation because of this. Or similarly, when you talk about all services, it is going to increase in the rate, which is going to be inflationary. See, when you're talking about inflationary, there are two areas which you have to look into this one. You have to look at the basket. The common man's basket consists of what items? If it is going to consist of at least predominantly of actually food items, that too agricultural produce, the inflation trend will not be higher. Because the reason it is, agricultural goods, still further it is going to be only exempted. It kept at least only as a 0%. Whatever inputs have gone for that, are they going to tax it or not? We have to wait. They can bring some exemption list. One. Second, when I say that it is one, basically when I'm talking about a GST, why at least, especially from the government side, they are also upbeat on this? Though some state governments are not upbeat, that's a different issue. Why government is on upbeat, at least, yes, telling that at least it will do good for actually the country?
Common market.
Common market. Apart from that, one of the reasons it is, they look at it as one, what you at least talked about is called kacha bill and pakka bill. What do you mean by that? Basically, the people who are at least selling the goods or even providing service, they don't rise at least one. When you're talking about kacha bill, it is nothing but what is that is going to happen? It is unaccounted. What at least I mentioned is one, most of the transactions will come into an accounting. The very purpose it is that it is, most of the transactions will be brought into account. That means, you know, at least there is a lot of studies and all those things, the parallel economy. The parallel economy, they say that it is equivalent to the current economy or even double the current economy. That is the way it is there. But what do you mean by that it is? When we are talking about at least the income by which at least it has not been accounted, unaccounted, that can come through, like if we are talking about kacha bill, it will be there. Why people are actually doing that? What is going to happen? GST, will they not do it at all? It is not necessary to do it. Somebody, people want to do it, they'll continue to do it. That's different. But their cost is going to be higher. The reason it is, the cost is going to be higher. Why the cost is going to be higher? Whatever they purchased it out, on which they might have paid a tax. For example, if they purchase the goods for 100, the tax, let us take 18%, 118. 100 plus 18, 118. When you are going to further sell it, when at least ask at least with bill or without bill, somebody says without bill, he says that okay, he will charge at least around 100 and because you have to keep his margin also. If you want to keep a margin of 20, you will say, okay, I will charge 120 to you. But what is the cost? Earlier he has paid, how much earlier he has paid? Earlier when he purchased, before GST when he purchased, he might have paid only 100 plus 5 or 2, whatever it is one. And he is ready to sell actually for 120. This 5 is immaterial for him. Anyhow, he is having a profit of 50. Okay. Now in GST scenario, what will happen? He has purchased at least 100 plus 18. He has to pay 18 now. When he sells to the party, it is one, without bill, for the same 120, if he is going to sell it out, what is the profit it is going to be for him now? 2. If you want to use the credit, if it is an accounted, he can use his 18 as a credit, which because already paid at the backward, it is one, that is available as a credit. As a result, still his margin can continue to be of 20. That is the reason, because of high cost will be there in the initial stage of VAT payment, which is available as a credit.